Hey boys and girls, I'm back again. We'll have another few days. I'm here till Sunday. It's now Tuesday morning. It's 20 past 10. I've come back to Wyreside. Sunny too. I'm nowhere near set up yet. My rods are just here. You can hear, that's where they are. We're in my bivvy again because it's quite a strong wind. Basically, same again, I'm here for the tench. I've got 5 nights to do it. I'm hoping for another couple for you. Try and get a bigger one this time, I think. Well, I'm hoping to try and get a bigger one for you this time. But we'll have to see how it goes. There's only me on. There's another angler on. He's on till Friday. I'm waiting for a friend called Dave. Mate Dave's coming up. He'd be here about 1 o'clock. He's only doing the night. He's after the carp. So, all in all, looks pretty good. I wouldn't say it's overly cold, but it's a bit of a nip. I wouldn't say it's nothing really. And we're getting later on in March now, aren't we, nearer to April. So, I'm hoping very shortly we'll have a few tents to show you. I'm still thinking on a name. Well, to be quite fair, I've got my phone somewhere. I've got a lot of names of what to call this series. So I'll read some of the names out later and I'll pick one. And whoever's name I pick, I'll give a mention to as well on the blog. How about that? They just keep coming. I've got about 30 to have a look through. There's some good ones, the odd silly one, as usual. But I'll see how it goes. So, yeah. I've actually turned the bivvy the opposite way around this time, so I'm actually facing the wind. Because it's a bit... The spot that I found last time, if you remember, is towards a bush on the point swim, like a tree. And my rods were too much at an angle going towards... Because it's a hard bottom. So I've turned the bivvy right round. Yeah, it's going to be a bit more uncomfortable. You're going to get a bit more wind on the blogs. But I'm straight at it now and I can fish with a bit of a... I wouldn't say too tight of a line, but a bit slacker. And they're a lot lower to the water, so they're not too far off the water. Last time they were like 2.5 feet, 3 feet off the water. And they were stuck up and the lines were bending one way. It weren't the best of angling, really. But I've picked this time. I'll show you the swim later. And I can see I've swapped everything around. I moved everything around. I'm in my different bivvy. Got my little one, my smaller one with me. So we'll see how that goes. But first of all, I'm going to get these things sorted. I'll make a brew and then I'm going to find that spot again, get everything clipped up. I've got it written down in my book. The book somewhere, I don't know where it is. And then I'll get some bait out and I'm going to leave it for half an hour. Just get my life sorted in here and off we go. So I'll speak to you all very shortly. Catch you in a bit. Right, rig number 2. I think I showed you in my last episode. I did. I'm not so sure. But basically, I got tungsten tubing, gravel colour. To be quite honest, it stands out a mile on this gravel. It's like a really, really light sandy colour, and it stands out like a mile as this one, to be fair. But anyway, the line's perfect. But I'm not too fussed about that. Right, first of all, lead. It's a 2 ounce lead. As you can see, I've got a quick change swivel. The rig that I'm using on these two, which I caught the fish on last time, I think we'll show you in depth, but it's very simple. It's just my maggot rig. As you can see on the bottom of the hook, big hook, main hook, there's a little hook that goes into the coin. I threw my maggots onto there, pull it up tight, and then I got a big bunch of maggots and a piece of coin, which is buoyant, mind you. And then if all the little nuisance fish, like your roach or whatever, come along and start pecking the maggots off one at a time, the coin will sit up. eventually, because with a hook inside the coin, it just balances it just right. And it's very short hook link. What's that? 3.5 inch to 4 inch. Bit of shrink tube on to help it get over. I find on these grower patches, I think shorter the better for me, all the way. And basically, before I cast it out, PVA bag is a must, because this piece of coin will wrap itself around the hook, and if you put it on a PVA bag or a couple of pieces of foam, sandwich it together, you find it doesn't do that, and it's a perfect presentation every time. Plus you're getting all them goodies, all that goodie around it, you know, and the stick mix, and it just goes on to the end of the thing. And I've also got a tail rubber that will go on there as well, an anti-tangle sleeve, and that is basically the rig. That is so easy, so simple. Catches tench, as you saw last in the last blog. I had two and lost one. So, that's that method sorted. Very simple. What can I say? Piece of cake. So, I'm about to do a bit of marker float work now in a minute. And then I'm going to get the finest spot, bait it up. I've only brought my marker rod with me today, for a simple reason. I can unclip it, take the marker off, and just put my spom on. It's a spom rod, it's actually a spod rod. It's a 5-pound test curve rod, so it's not a problem. You know, I do like a stiff rod for my marker work. So, I'll probably show you a bit of that in a minute. But hey ho, time to get on with it. And I'll speak to you all very soon and see how we get on. Let's aim it for a bit now. I'm kind of settled in. Right, boys and girls, here you are. That's my marker. As you can see, it's clipped up on my reel. Now, the thing that I always do when I'm marker floating, this will kind of make you think. It's clipped up to my first whipping on my rod. So that's 1 foot. 2 foot. Now, what I'm going to do, as you can see, that's clipped up, is put the bait runner on. I'm going to take it all out till it hits the clip, and then I'm going to take this to the spigot on the rod. See, that's round by the spigot on the rod. So I'm going up to the first eye now, and then I'm going to reclip it. I'm going to wind it back on. I'll just wind it all tight for a second. Now, basically, what I've done that is when I cast out now to my a spot that I found, the marker will travel past the spot, and when I bring it back, as I'm feeling the rod, when that marker hits that first whipping, I know I'm on that spot every time. Because if I was to leave it clipped up and cast, it hits the rod, it could bounce back a bit, and you're not on the spot that you want to be on. Now, this is the only way that, this is the way I do it. I might be wrong, you know. I've got some new line on my reels, which is it's a mono line. It's really no stretch in it whatsoever, so I can probably clip them up to the same spot, move it on a foot or two, and then I know when I cast, because it's got all the stretch in the line. It's actually the quarter touchdown I'm using. And as it hits the clip, I know it's going to be around that area, because there's nothing worse than casting and overshooting the mark or undershooting it. To me, that's not really effective fishing, is it? But I might be wrong. We'll have to wait and see. So I'm going to quickly wind this in, and I've quit another go again. Feel it back, make sure I hit the spot. I'm happy with that spot, and then I swap all over to the spud rod to just put the spum on it, and away we go. So I will speak to you all soon. As you can see, you're literally behind my rods. There's my marker float, there's a tree in front. When the marker float comes in and spum goes on, that bush, that tree, will be my marker then for the rest of the session. So there you have it. I didn't show you last time, but that's the spot. So it's literally 10 wraps out now. I've come up 8 feet to make it, you know, 10. It's nice and gravelly, you know, it's no big bumpy, big boulders are out in there. It's all nice and smooth gravel. So it's easy fishing. And the problem is if I cast too hard with normal mono, I have that danger of probably overshooting, and then I'm in the silty area, the clay area, which I don't really want. I want to be in the gravel. So there you have it, that's my spot, and let's try and get a few. Right, a bit of a quick update. It is now time we got to. It is 20 past four. I've had a few bips and bops. I think there's a few fish in the area, a few liners, that's about it. Getting pestered with the ducks. My mate Dave's here, he's on the next peg down. So I'm hoping tonight there's going to be a few fireworks. I'm going to put a bit more bait out before it gets dark, probably about 6 o'clock. Redo the rigs. Get them back out, hopefully on the same spot. And we'll see how it goes for tonight. So I've got a few different options. You know, different things. I've got different hook baits, I've got my maggots, obviously casters, so I can try different things, and we'll see how it goes. Tomorrow, I'll quickly tell you, I'm having a change around tomorrow. I'm only going to be fishing with two rods, on the buzzers, on the alarms, plus I'm going to be doing a bit of float fishing. I'm going to start pre-baiting an area just here in front of me, and see if I can winkle one or two out, or some big roach, even. On the old float rod. So that should be fun. It's going to be a nice day tomorrow. Let's see what we can get. So, as for now, this is going to be the last update, unless I catch one in the night. We'll see how we go. But right now, I'm going to make a brew. And I'm going to chill out with Dave, I think. Have a brew, see what he's up to. Have a laugh. I'll spin you around so you can see. He's in the next peg. I'll just move you across so you can see. He's there in the next peg. So, see what he's up to, I think. He's been fishing a couple of hours now. So he's only doing 24 hours. I'll try and get him on cam for you if he gets his fish, so you can see. So, right, I'm off. Speak soon. Right, boys and girls, it's now 5 o'clock. And first tench, just as I was making my tea. The first tench of the session. It's a big, big, nice 6 pound 5 ounce. Immaculate fish. Absolutely beautiful. Big female. Ripping rum. Oh, I'm over the moon. First one of the session. Oh. Can't beat the first one of the session, can you? So, I'm just going to do a few stills of this fish. Right, quickly. Homie mate Dave's here. Kindly for me. So, I'll speak to you lot very shortly. Over the moon. First fish, £6.5. Only been here about 6 hours. Brilliant. So, catch you all soon. There she goes. Buzzing. First one in the bag on a long session. Can't go wrong with that, can you? I just rung Sally to tell him that I've got one, see if he wanted to take it to Fox's Lake, but there's nobody about. So safest and easiest thing to do to let her go back home. Hope she tells all her friends to come and have a go at my upgrade. How about that? So, it's 5 ounce bigger than the last two that I had last week, so let's see if we can get another, this time a bigger one. 10 would be nice, wouldn't it? Yeah, 10. But anyway, that's all off that bait spot that I showed you earlier, as well as the bait I'm using, the rigs. Well nailed. Job done. Cup of tea time, I think. So I'll speak to you all later. Well, it is now Wednesday morning. And bloody hell, I'll tell you, it was cold last night, lads. What should I say, boys and girls? The sun's beaming down now. Probably, that's why my face is probably bright white. But I tell you, yeah, I was up till about 11:30. I was listening to the football. But I was also just all hoping and praying that one was going to rip off, but it got really, really cold. And then I went to bed, like you do. And sure as hell, half an hour later, it rips off. So I gets out, strikes into it, felt something, then it fell off. So that was my middle rod. So I quickly wound it back in. Got on the distance sticks, measured back out, a new stick, few new maggots, back out onto the spot. 2 hours later, an hour and a half later, bang, the left hand rod goes. My God, same again, struck into it, felt it, it fell off. Now, I think I knew what the problem was, is because I was too lazy yesterday to make some new rigs. And the rig that I'm using, as you've all seen, is this one. Is that one there, and I don't know if you can see, it's a little rig. That's all it is, it's a little rig. It's a 3 to 3.5 inches, and I put this big thing on, nearly 7 inches long. I think the tench were getting rid of it pretty easy, and I think that's what we're doing it, that's what was making them fall off. I think the rig was too long. These I tend to use for more from a helicopter rig. When I'm using the Magaliner, when I've got a big bunch of maggots in a bag, where it could hang down and clip under the bag of maggots. That's why these are a bit longer. But well, I've learnt by that mistake. So I swapped all over this morning, well, last night. And this morning I've put new rigs on, new bags, I've rebaited, spawned out a load. And then hopefully, today we've got a nice breeze coming in. The sun's out, it's warm in the water hopefully. And bag one or two. We can only hope, can't we? So, but I'm only fishing with two rods now on the buzzes. I'm going to bait a spot just over here later on with some hemp and casters, a few maggots, and I'm thinking about doing a bit of float fishing. Catch a few roach maybe, and might try using worms if I can get a tench. We can only see, can't we? So we'll catch up a little later on, I think. So, right, that's a little waffling. I'll see you all later. Perfect. Right, boys and girls. 4:30 in the evening. Half an hour ago, I was just spotting that hemp and corn out. And I said to you, everything was set for the trap. So here we are. It's not big, it's only £4.14. It's a very, very fiery male. As you can see, before it starts being a silly sod. Nice fish, put up a really good fight, good run, £4.14, over the moon. That's the fourth tench of the year, second one of the trip. It seems to be this time of the night when they're coming to. So I'm going to put this one back and try and get another one. Happy days. It's a bit fiery, this thing. So I'll speak to you all very soon. Right, quick sit wrap. You've just seen, I just had another fish, a male. It was 414, sorry. Came from that bait spot that I just showed you before the fish. I felt confident, the cast, the touchdown, where the lead hit the bottom, felt a donk. Yeah, I'm buzzing. So second day, second fish. Would like a few more fish, but you know, you got to take what comes. I lost two last night. I would say there would have been tench. So I've got my third rod back out straight away. As soon as that fish was in the net, it was a case of get a PVA bag on it, back out. And I've just put another two spawn full out over the spot. Because tench do like the noise of the spawn hitting, ringing the dinner bell, as they say. They're very inquisitive, but they're definitely moving. I've seen a few bubbles out there earlier today when it was sunshine and it was quite warm. Probably about 2:30 o'clock. So all in all, it's looking very good. Time is now 5:15. So it was 4 o'clock when I spawned. I got the rods back out by about 20 past. And at 5:30 it ripped off. Yeah. I'll post some pictures up later on my like page for the people that want to see. The ducks are back. So yeah, over the moon. Let's see what else we can catch. Oh, I've been catching roach as well today on the float rod, so you know. That's why I'm fishing with two, float fishing with a third. Using my third rod, if I catch one, or I need to, you know, put a fresh bait out, I use that straight out. That's how I've been doing it. Making things quick and easy, simple. Two rods are enough, because I'm bad for it, you get three rods out, you get one run, and if it takes all up the other two lines out, it's a pain in the arse, untangling everything at the middle of the night. At least with two, you're not too bad. You can steer it away, and especially because it's either left or right. It's when you hit the middle one that's the worst. So anyway, I'll catch you all later. The sun's been out today. I've got a bit of a headache because of the sun. So I'm hoping it's going to be a bit warmer tonight. So speak to you all soon. Right guys, just a quick, I wouldn't say it's a plug, but there's one thing that I always take with me if I'm tench, bream, a roach machine or whatever, is this stuff. Medicarp. I can't really say too much about it. Most of you, 99.9% of you will do. Even with a tench, I even put it on the mouths when I've had a hook in it. Or any problems on the body, I'll just stick a bit of that on. It's just a bit of a cliche, as it would say, but very important. Even though I'm a tench angler and bream angler, I still use it. Because I got respect for the fish. If I catch a carp and it's torn up, whatever, I still use it. Because I think about other fish as well, you know, it's not just for the tench and the bream, it's whatever I catch. So there you are. But that's about it really for tonight. It's now, I think it's 6:30. Is it 6:30? It's 6:20. So I'm gonna, my last blog of tonight, so it's Wednesday today, Thursday tomorrow. Let's hope that we get a few more in the day, or maybe even a couple tonight. see how we get on. So, and I will, tomorrow I will run through these names for the series name, shall we say, for the blog series. There's a few names on there, quite funny really. I'll just quickly run through some of them. Where are we? Here we are. I'll just give you a couple of... One chap called Paul. Tonic Tales, which is a good name, isn't it? And then you've got People Being Stupid. And we've got Wenches and Tenches from Sean, my mate. Wenches and Tenches. The Red Eye Monsters. That's another one. Green with Envy. That's Ant Smith. Gary Page's Tinchy Stalker. It's not a bad one, is it? My mate Dave, I was fishing wee, because he's a southerner and we're being a bit sarcastic, he want me to call it Hello Monkey. If you don't know what that means, is it means because I'm a northerner. The southerners call northerners northern monkeys, and we call them the southern fairies. What else have we got? Tales from the Green Side, that's Mick Bell, another good lad. The Tench Commandment, that's from Andy, another friend. I'll tell you another good one, this is from Mark West. It's the In Search of the Mighty Tonics. Damien Bolton, he has a couple, Tonic Time, or Tales of the Tonic, which we've already had, Under the Lilies, from Stevie Albert, or Thinking About Under the Lilies. There's some good ones there, isn't there? So I'll probably, tomorrow I might have another quick whiz through them, and I'll pick one. And we'll see how it goes, and we'll start using that as my name, I think, for the series. This just for this Tench season, but I won't be, like I said to my mate Dave before, I'm only doing blogs just for this year. The reason why I'm doing them is only because people keep asking me if I do them for them and whatever. So I said I'd give it a go. So far, so good. I've had no trolls as such. Everyone's been all right with me, and some good reviews on some of the videos. But the early ones were a bit shoddy because I obviously didn't really know what I was doing. But I'm gonna do just this season for the tension they bring through the summer, for the spring and the summer, and then probably autumn. But that'll probably be it, you know. I'm not really... I need a better camera, in all honesty. I need one where I can put a sound muffler on it, stop the wind from making all the silly noises that it does when you're trying to talk and explain something, and you're trying to blog. That's a pain in the arse. But we'll see how it goes, you know. So this summer, spring and summer, this is the only time I'm going to be blogging. So I'll do as much as I can, get it on there, and hopefully I can catch some nice fish in between. And it's just showing my experiences with you people who watches them, and all the people on my Facebook groups and my like page. They're always watching them and telling me how good they are and what they want to know. So I mean, I'm not the best angler in the world, but I do catch one or two. There's far better anglers out there than me. I mean, I just do it because I enjoy doing it, and that's it, you know. It's the only thing that keeps me going. But I don't have a life as such. Fishing is my life. You know, I don't drink, I don't smoke, I don't go out. This is all I do. So, but as far as the names go for the series, I will I'll have another gander through, and I'll post it probably tomorrow now, on another blog, another update. I'll give them the name, what I'm going to call it, and we'll see how we get on. So anyway, it's 6:30 now, been rabbiting for 7 minutes. The light is going, well, it's gone. A tench has just literally rolled. Don't think you can see with a camera over the baited spot. Oh, the wind's probably taking it away. On this, if you can see, no, it's probably a bit too dark for you to see, maybe. But they are rolling. I've seen two now roll over that spot, just over there. So I'm hoping for some fireworks tonight. So anyway, I'll see you all soon. And let's see how we get on. See you all later. Right, here we are. Fish number 4. It's only a baby, it's only 4 pound 11. Big female, but small female. There she is. She's only a little spirited little fight. Good condition. Absolutely over the moon, middle of the day as well. It's only, it's about 1 o'clock I think it is. I'm not so sure, but I'll tell you later. So the rods have been out a couple of hours. Been busy this morning getting things ready. It's a beautiful day. It's about to go to another lake, is this little thing, to get bigger. Right now, I'm gonna put it back in the sling, in the captive mat, so it can breathe for a little while before it gets taken. Over the moon. Let's keep them going. Good afternoon, welcome back. It's not a right lot to say, really. I've been quite busy today. Just a one fish at 1 o'clock. Earlier on, I said it was my fourth fish. It's not, sorry, it's my third fish of the session. The fifth of the season. There's not a real lot that's been happening, to be quite fair. There was a lad, a bloke over there early today, rinsing them out at River Lake. He was bringing carp out. I've just been busy doing a bit of cleaning, getting a few things sorted out, getting myself back in order. Tonight's going to be a bit better weather, so I might do a bit of float fishing tonight, through the night, with worm, casters and hemp. Let's see how that goes, if I can catch one that way. But it's getting towards bite time. It's roughly about this time of the day when I get a bite. So, any time now I'm open. Between all 4 and 5. Let's hope one goes. I think I put the kibosh on it the other day when I said I want a bigger fish than 6 pound 5. The last two have been smaller. I suppose that's how it goes, isn't it? But I'm not too bothered. Tench is a tench. I'm fishing, I'm catching. I ain't bothered if it's 2 pound. So let's just hope something else comes along. It is actually Thursday evening now. Yeah, Thursday evening. I've not done a lot of blogging today, to be quite fair. I've been quite busy sourcing bait out and getting things ready. You know, making my PVA mixes up, PVA bags ready. Very simple. But I was looking through the phone today at the name for the blog, for the series, should I say, there. And to be quite fair, there's a lot of good ones. I can only pick one, and I think I'm going to have to pick, let's get it back up, and I'll say who it was. tonic tails I'm going to go for. That's Gary Page. He suggested that one. So that's what we're going to call the series. Tonic Tails, I think. That's a good name. There's that many, to be honest. There's about 30, I think. Tales of the Tonic, that was another one I want to call it. But I think Gary's hit the nail on the head there. With Tonic Tales. So that's it, that's the new series. This is what this series, this spring, this summer, is going to be called. So, Tonic Tales. So this will be Tonic Tales, episode 2. This one. So, yeah, pretty good. So I'm stopping for a bite. Hopefully get another fish. My tea will be here in a bit. Get it delivered. It's very good food here as well. Very good food. So, anyway, I'm just waffling on. There's not a right lot to show you, to be honest, because it's all the same as last time. I'm using hemp casters, maggot, red maggot, and corn in the spod mix. That's all I'm using. I bought some boilies today. And what I've done with these, I've just crumbed them up. Basically, what I've done, I've just crumbed them up, and then this way, it's a case of I have another option if I need to go onto a boilie. You know, I can use that as a PVA bag, as you can see. PVA bag, I can PVA bag. It's krill, this. Oh, it smells absolutely beautiful, though. They were 12 mil boilies, freezer baits. And I've just put them in my little crusher. I've done a kilo of them. It just gives me another dimension. You know, I can put it in my spod mix, I can put it in bags. I might even fish in the margin with it, yeah? On my third rod later in the week. So that's that one. And the stick mix that's been doing all the damage is this one. This is my Mix Blitz, yeah, from Hinders with a glug. Just put that in, mix it all up, and bag it. It's a real fishy smell. I've been putting one of them on over my hook so the rig don't get tangled. And I think that's what's been doing the trick, in all fairness. Over the moon with that. And then the second one. Quite, it's not unique, it's just casters and CSL with a bit of ground bait in them. As you can see, this one here, I was going to fire out earlier on, but I didn't get around to doing it. All I'm going to do is clip that onto my quick link and away it goes. Plenty of food, that's on rubber casters, is this one. If you can see, that's just rubber casters, but I've not tried that rig yet. I've stepped with a corn and the fake corn and maggots. That's what's been doing the business. It's what did the business last time. Does seem a bit stupid to change it, but I might just try this margin. Because it's been really warm today, in all fairness. It's been very hot. I've been in my shirt all day. It's been beautiful weather. And I had that fish during the day, which is different. It's normally in the late afternoon, about now, 4 o'clock onwards, the time I get one. But, it's going to be a bit warmer tonight as well. Let's see how we get on. Hopefully I can get one or two in the night. You know, this place is not full of tench. You know, there is tench in. You know, you're not going to go and bag, say, 10 a day. You know, I get 3 or 4 a day if you're lucky. And I've had 3 and I've been here since Tuesday. The biggest being 6.5. There is big fishing, there is big tension here. I've had them to 8 and that went back in. You know, it only takes is one one bite, one run, and it could be a 10 pounder, it could be an 8 pounder. You just don't know, do you? You know, this is what big fish hunting's all about. You are waiting around a lot of the time, you know, and you've got to accept it. You're not always going to catch, or if you do, it's not always going to be a big one. You know, it's sacrifice, I think they call it, don't they? Yeah, a bit of give and take. So, yeah, that's enough of me rambling on. I'll get some things sorted for tomorrow. Hopefully my tea will be here, and you never know, I might have a fish to show you. So I'll speak to you all later on. Good evening, bye bye. God, this sun's driving me wacky, it's in my eyes. See you later. Right, boys and girls, here's another one. It's a beauty, it's not anything big. It's what? £5.3. Another nice fish. Another one for the photo album. This is the fish number 4, not number 3. Over the moon. Beautiful, £5.3, fish number 4. The last one was fish number 3. So there you have it. Good fighter. Well, let's get her back, hey? Right, quick update. Friday afternoon. It's half past 25 to 3. I'm just gonna quickly run you through what I'm about to do. I've not explained it properly enough, I don't think, through the blog, that when I'm fishing, like I'm doing now, I'm fishing with two rods and one settle. So if I get another fish, that rod comes out with a fish on, put it in the net, put this clipper up, because it's very simple, I'm loop to loop, onto the quick change swivel, as you can see there. And I fire it straight back out onto that spot, because I'm getting a fish every 24 hours. I'm trying to keep the bait going in, you know, I'm trying to keep them there, but it's not happening, in all fairness. You know, there's not a lot of tench here, I know that. So I'm still catching tench. But the thing is, this is how I'm doing it, every 3 hours, say 9 o'clock, well, at 9 o'clock in the morning, I start at 9. Bring all the rods in, all new sticks, all new maggots on the bait, fire it back out, and I put 6 bomb full of bait out. 6 bomb full, and then I leave it till 3, till about 1, 12, 1, any time really. Give it 3, good 3 hours, and then put another 2 spombs out over the spotted, over your spotted area, over your baited area. And then at 3 o'clock, I bring the rods back in again. Redo them, send them back out, and then put another further 3 spawnful out on top of that, and then leave it till it gets dark, bring them back in, which is about 6:30, 7 o'clock here, where it's getting dark out. If it's a nice day, redo them, fire them back out, another couple of spawns, and then leave it all the way through the night. If I have a fish, I will obviously cast this rod straight out on top of the spotted area, on the baited area, and then I'll put another couple of spawnful out in the night if I have a fish. But that's how I'm doing it, just so you know. And another quick thing for you to say about the rig that I'm using, which is this one. I'll probably do a blog later on and show you how to tie this rig. I mean, it's doing the business for me, it has done for a couple of years. It's a good tench rig, it's a good bream rig as well, you know, it'll catch you all. The problem with this rig is, the reason why I do it every 3 hours, well, every 6 hours, shall I say, when they redo the baiting, put the new sticks and stuff on, is because the maggots are put on the end of you, the roach will attack them. And every now and again, you get a few beeps, a few taps on the end of the rod, and what that is the roach pulling the maggots off end of the coin, and it can be a pain in the arse. But it's not a real pain, because you've still got a good presentation out there with coin. You know, you've got still got a nicely, you know, the coins, the hook's flat on the bottom, and the coin's stuck up. You know, it's still balanced, it's still alright, it still works. I had one, my second tench, I think it was on the last blog, that came out just on the coin. So it's not a problem, but I do like to keep the odd maggot around it for a bit of attraction and, you know, a bit of colour and a bit of movement. But that's, you know, what I'm trying to say, you know, you've got to be careful with this rig. The maggots will pull the bloody, the roach and stuff will pull the maggots off the rig. If you get a beep and a bumping on your rod, it's basically a roach. Sometimes I will bring it in and recast it if I know that's happened. Or I just leave it. But it's a 50-50 rig, it depends how I feel. Probably 7 out of 10 times I will bring it in and redo it and cast it, because everything's clipped up, I'm not too far out. So that's a little tip for you if you're going to use this rig. But I will do a blog at some point on this journey on how to tie this rig. I did it in my last blog, but I've deleted that blog with it on, so I'll redo it for you. So I've been asked a couple of times now of 2 or 3 people if I would, you know, do that blog and how to tie this rig. It's very simple, so easy. It's just three main components really that you need, and it's pretty simple. So I'll show you that later on. So I'll catch you all soon. Maybe we'll have a fish. Have a bigger one too. Right, I'll catch you later.
Right, here we go. This is the bit of the rig that I'm going to show you. As you can see, I'm sorry for the extreme close-up. In real life, you won't want to be next to me, not at the moment, because I smell like a Romanian jockstrap. But anyway, that's for another day. Right, the rig. Can you see? It's basically, the coin is slid on to the braided line, braided hook link. And I tied on a size 14 Guru hook, barbless. Now, it's only my opinion, mind you, but I do prefer a straight shanked barbless hook for this method. Now, I find this pattern of hook from Guru, a size 14, it works really well with the Enterprise pop-up coin. I mean, you can use any colour you want. I mean, I just use yellow because it's yellow. This one's scented. That's Tutti Frutti, I think that one is. And basically, that's all it is, the end piece. That is probably the most difficult bit to tie. Now, as you can see, all you do is you just get it and you shove it into the coil. Obviously, you'll put maggots on the end of there. But one tip with this rig, I've never really tried it with fluorocarbon. By the way, I'll just say to you, I've never tried it with fluorocarbon. It probably work, but I'm not really into, how can I put it, I like the flexibility on the hair for this particular rig myself, only myself. Some of you might find it's better with fluorocarbon. I mean, that's entirely up to you, you can do it how you want, you know, but this is the mechanics of the rig. It's not my rig. In all fairness, I think I pinched this off Thinking Tackle. I watched Adam Penning do it. But basically, I've done it in a different way to him, because he had a hair hook link with a fluorocarbon boom. But I'm using braid all the way through. I just find it works. I mean, results speak for themselves, don't they? I find it works well for me. And if you look at the pictures, I'll put some pictures up of the hook holds of the tench that I've been catching, which, in my opinion, you know, tench are bloody good at getting rid of rigs. Now, this hook, it nails them in the bottom of the lip, or in the centre of the lip. It nails them proper. It nails them well and good. So, basically, as you all know, you're not stupid, are you? That is the mechanics of it. That is the bit you really need. You know how to tie it, and that's to tie a size 14 hook on the bottom of your hair. But slide your coin on first. and then push it on. But I tend to keep the coating on this because this is a coated hook link. I tend to keep the coating on and strip it just a piece back. And this is how I tend to do the knotless knot with it. It's basically the hooks I'm using are these. A size 10. I think these hooks are brilliant, to be honest. I think they're sharp as hell. Strong. They've never let me down. I think they are really, really... And they're only, what, £1.25 a packet. Bloody brilliant hook, in my opinion. Absolutely brilliant. So, basically, here's the knotless knot. As you all know how to do knotless knot. I'm not going to explain that to you. Let's face it. My friend's grandma could do it. But the key trick is... I find with this particular rig is to keep a bit of clearance between the hook and the coin. For simple reason, when you pull the hook out, the coin's got to go somewhere, and I find that just a few mil tends to work. And just, all I do is a knotless knot. What I tend to do is put five wrap round five times, and then wrap round a sixth time, and as you can see, I don't think you can see that well, but I'm actually onto the coating of the hook link. So once I've done the once round the bottom and the coated, and I'll just do it round again, round twice, back up the shank, and then through the eye. For a simple reason, I like it to be stiff from the hook onwards, and that way, I won't say it acts like a fluorocarbon, but it acts stiff, and it kind of helps to, well, helps turn the hook, and I think it helps tangles when you're casting out. But that is basically it. It's so simple. I mean, TikTok in there for you. That's very simple, like that. And basically what I'm going to do now is just get a piece of shrink tube. Just cut a piece off, and I will shrink it down later. I'll shrink it down and put the shrink tube over it. That is basically, this is basically the rig, and that's all I'm using. I'll just put the shrink tube on. Obviously you'll shrink the tube down once it's on, but I'll put the shrink tube on to help give it a bit of a more of an aggressive angle to turn the hook. Plus, in my opinion, it neatens everything up because I'm OCD, and that's about as much as I put on. I don't know if you can see. Hey, I'm sorry for the close-up again. Don't worry, I'm not going to try and kiss you. So there's that, and basically here's one in true Blue Peter style. I had made up, as you can see, it's just there. And basically, let's get what I do. Is if I can find a maggot or two. Got some maggots on here. Just for the demo to show you people. And just stick a maggot on the hook. This is the rig, it's very simple. As you can see, all my blogs aren't scripted. I just do it. I'll keep it real. Stupid, to be quite honest. But there's the gist of it, as you can see. But I will put roughly six maggots on there. I'm told six or seven, up to you. Like a big bunch of maggots. And then get your gate latch needle, your big needle, and get a bag. These are the bags. I'm using Blitz Mix, and I'm mixing it with a Blitz Mix additive, the liquid, the glug. Really fishy, really, really fishy. I've only really been using it this past two trips. This is the first time I've ever used it, and I've got to say, I don't know if it's made any difference, but personally, confidence-wise, every fish I've caught has had a bag of this on. And it disguises the hook link, you know, it hides it a little, leaves a bit of a pile. Yeah, I think I'm going to start using this a lot more, to be quite honest. I mean, it's not it's, I think it's £20 for a 5 kilo bag of blitz mix. And it's not over dear, is it really? But here is what I'm doing. I just get the bag. As you can see, I've just threaded it right through. I mean, a lot of you know how to do this, but for the lads who don't, I mean, this is not for me, it's for the young lads that keep messaging me, asking me how I tie it. And then he's got your pointy needle, and you just, it is, it's a very effective rig. There you are, and that's basically it. That's the rig. I'm not Danny Fairbrass, as you can tell. You know, it's very, very short, this rig. Come on a hard bottom. I'm literally on gravel. So I want it very short, and like I say, I'll put some pictures up of the fish that I've caught where I've hooked them. And they've all been nailed. They have, they've been properly nailed. And that's basically it, that's simple. And it's, what's it going on? It's just going on a normal lead setup. We've got some dark matter tubing, which is in gravel brown. To be honest, it sticks. It's not the best for this here, but normally I have some water-soluble pens, and I normally colour them in my tubing. But to be honest, I've left them at home. I'm annoyed about that, to be honest. But it hasn't made any difference, I'm still catching them. And it's just down to a 2 ounce lead with a quick change swivel. I mean, at the beginning of this blog, you'd have seen the rig that I'm using, and that's it. You know, it's, that's all I've used all day. The past 3 days I've been here, and that's, yeah, that's all it is. It's just a lead set up, inline lead, down to a bag of stick mix with a hook and everything there, and that's it. I mean, it's been doing the business. But when I do cast out, it hits the good thing about these flat pairs, it does lie flat well, and you know, you get a good donk. Plus with the new main line I'm using the Corder Touchdown, which apparently hasn't got as much stretching. And I'm actually finding it quite decent, actually. I do quite like it. And I'm feeling the lead downfill really well. But once I've put the, once it's felt down, I will let the line sink just a little. Just so this heavy tungsten tubing lies flat, and it's covered, you know, it's not obscene, so the fish can't really see it. And it's done really well this week as that. I mean, I've only had 4 fish. Don't forget, there's not a lot of fish in here. It's not Horseshoe, where it's full of tench and good tench. There is good fish in here. It's picking them out. At the end of the day, I've been on since Tuesday, and I'm the only person that's catching. I've not seen another carp angler catch yet. So obviously, it's working well. It's doing what I want it to do. And it's I'm enjoying myself, and that's all I'm bothered about, you know. These blogs wouldn't be any fun if there weren't any fish in them, would they? You know, anybody can talk a good fishing session, but I'm catching the fish. And there you are. That is basically it. Hinders blitz mix, it's a real fishy. I mean, I haven't spotted it now. I'm only putting it just in the bag. Just in the bag, that's all I'm using it for. I mean, I brought a couple of kilo with me, and it's going to last the 6 days that I'm here. So, over the moon with this. Good rig, give it yourself. Give it a go yourself. You know, and that's how you tie it, basically, like I showed you. This is one I had done earlier. But one little tip with a rig. When you've made your rig, I mean, I make them because I've got quite big fingers, you see. As you can see, the braid's quite long. But when I finish with it, I do make the actual rig pretty short. And I mean very short, in all honesty. Because of the hard bottom. I mean, it's 3.5 inches at the max, and that's all I need. And yeah, it's doing the business for me, in all honesty. So there you have it. And just a quick point, that when you're doing this sort of fishing, obviously I've got one rod, my third rod's always stacked up at the side of the pivot, ready to go, it's clipped up. All I've got to do is basically attach a rig and it's back out on that spot within minutes, absolute minutes. And I think that's key when you're tench fishing, or any fishing really, bream fishing. When the fish are there, you want to be capitalising on them as much as you can. So that's what I've done. So as you can see in this little tub, I've got a lot of sticks ready. Ready to go, ready to rock and roll. And my mix is there, so if I need to make some more, I'd soon bang some up. It only takes a couple of minutes to do a few. And another thing, if you can see, this gunge, this is basically the liquid of the Blitz mix, and I'm just dipping the PVA bag in it because it's PVA friendly. Dip it in, bit of a subtraction, back out on the spot, it's a winner. It really is a winner. So there you have it. That's my rig. It's the only real rig I've used another rig at the beginning of the session. But the problem with that, I was catching quite a few roach on it. So I've just gone over to two rods, and I've been using my float rod. I've been catching roach on my float rod as well. This is for something to do in the day, you know, it's passing time. It's very deep out in front of me. It's about 12 feet actually in one place, 11 foot. And I've been using maggots, just like I said, just for something to do in the day, just to pass the time. So that's basically the rig and everything else I'm using. I've got some casters in the CSL ready to go as well. I mean, I haven't tried that yet, but that's another option. If I wanted to, I could have one on the maggot and coring, and I can have one on my maggot rig, on my caster rig, which works just as well. In all honesty, it is another good rig. But the difference with that one, you've got to put the PVA bag on the outside, so you've got to tie it to the hook. You might have seen earlier on in this blog that I did slide a PVA stick down, and then I put the bag of casters at the bottom, because tench love casters, you know. I mean, I've had some good tench over the years on just on casters. So there you have it. Very simple rig, like I say. Main thing is keep it short, keep it stiff. Obviously, if you're on silt, make it a bit longer, or weed, make it a bit longer. But in all honesty, I did have two tench fall off on me earlier in the week, and I put that down to the hook looking too long myself. That's what I put that down to. But if I was fishing on silt, I would fish other rigs. I wouldn't really fish that one. I would fish other rigs. Probably be an helicopter style of rig that I would fish. But anyway, that's for another day. When I get round to it, and for fish a week, a silty place like Horseshoe, I'm going to Horseshoe this year. It's very silty, weedy, should I say, and I'll show you the rigs that I would use down there. So that's something to look forward to for you, if you're still watching these vlogs. So anyway, I've rambled on enough now, I think, about that rig. It's a very, very good rig. Very, very good rig. Give it a try. I mean, the feedback I'm getting on Facebook about it, people love it. So yeah, so good rig. I mean, I've got a lot of bream this winter on that rig as well. That was a helicopter style. That was a longer rig, but it still incorporated everything there, but it was a different colour of hook link. And it also had a piece of silicone on to help the hook flip over. But that was another good session as well on that rig. So right, I've gone 16 minutes of my time I've took now, or 16 minutes of your time I've took for you to watch this. So I'll get back to you all very shortly. Right, I'll give you a bit of a quick update. I think it is Saturday afternoon, 4 o'clock. There's not been a lot happening, to be quite honest. I was knackered today. I got up this morning, did everything I had to do. Cast out at 9 o'clock, baited up at 9, and I went back to bed for a couple of hours. I was absolutely goosed. I've had nothing today, not at all. My rods have just gone back out. I've changed over to the same rig. Instead of putting live maggots on the end of the hook, I've put fake ones. So I've got fake coring and fake maggots.
but the core is sinking and not a pop up one, but the maggots are buoyant. So I'm hoping it can stay out longer, because the roach are just mullering me maggots to bits. You know, you get little taps and little beeps from them. So I've just thought, right, I'll swap over. And the so far, it's worked, because they've been out for the last 5 hours. I brought them in and no problems. Had a couple of beeps. But they're trying to, you know, how can I put it? Destroy the rubber, but they can't. So, yes. It's nearly tea time. So next blog, I'll either be in the morning saying that I'm going, or I have a fish. I hope I've got another couple of fish to come yet, but we'll have to see, won't we? So I'll get back to you. I have a first thing in the morning when I'm going. I'm going about 8 o'clock, half eight. Or in between that, there might be a fish. If not, I'll see you in the morning. Right, that's me done now then. I think I'm going home in the next hour. No more fishing tonight, and a problem with the ducks. So I think time to go home, get some more bait ordered, get some bits and bobs ordered, and I'll hopefully be back within the next week or so. Got a few things to do next week, so I can't get back as early as I wanted. So, yeah, it's been a good session. 4 fish, lost a couple, never mind it, let's just keep going. The weather's getting better, it's still bitterly cold this morning, but hey, that's the idea of fishing. Get out here doing it, no good being at home, sat on your ass, scratching your balls, is it? Getting out here and doing it is the thing. Anyway, I'm going, so thanks for watching if you're watching this to the end. It's going to be a big one, but I'll see you all on the bank sometime soon. Catch you later.